Warning: New World Currency Reserve BRICS will kill the US dollar. With the goal of overtaking the US dollar as the most dominant currency in the world, a few international leaders of several of the most powerful nations in the world have united and made an alliance to create a new currency called BRICS. Member nations, which include Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa, will create this new currency that will be in direct competition with the US dollar to become the world standard and most widely used currency in the world. Thus, the US dollar will soon face a significant challenge from this new currency. Could this new currency kill the US dollar? Hi and welcome back to another video of Finance Sense, where we cover all the latest trends in the financial markets and the economy. Before we begin, make sure to like this video, subscribe, and click on the notification bell to stay updated with our videos. Now, let's get to the video proper. An alliance of nations has been working together to establish the new World Currency Reserve, which will replace the United States dollar as a global reserve currency. To start, we have to turn first to the existing holders of the most powerful currencies in the world, the G7. The US, UK, Canada, Japan, and the European Union are all members of the G7, a partnership of some major global economies. It was formerly known as the G8, but it was renamed the G7 in 2014 after Russia's membership was terminated as a result of the invasion of Crimea. By fostering closer political and economic connections among its members, the G7 aims to maintain the dominance of the West in the world's power structure, while also ensuring that its currency continues to be the most powerful on the globe. Of the top six trading currencies in the world, five are the currencies of the G7 nations, with the US dollar at the top of the list. The G7 primarily wants the US dollar to continue being the world's most powerful currency. Because if the US dollar retains its dominance, the other G7 currencies will likely follow, maintaining the West's overall supremacy. However, the G7's tight grip on the global economy may loosen, and BRICS is directly responsible. The G7, which consists of the seven largest emerging economies in the world, is mainly challenged by BRICS, which stands for Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. The countries that make up BRICS alone don't pose much of a danger to the West, but when they come together, things look quite different. BRICS nations now comprise more than 40% of the global population and 31.5% of the global GDP. Nevertheless, the IMF predicts that the BRICS nations will make up half of the world's GDP by 2030, just 8 years away, and that's without factoring in any potential new members. Recently, Argentina formally joined BRICS, and according to reports, Iran may soon follow, while Turkey, Egypt, and Saudi Arabia are all considering joining. The combined supremacy of the BRICS countries pose a significant threat to Western domination, and it would appear that they are aware of this because the US currency is their primary target. The BRICS nations gather annually to discuss how a cooperative alliance may develop in the future. The BRICS dropped a financial bomb on the US currency during the 14th annual summit in June this year. Vladimir Putin, the president of Russia, unveiled BRICS plans to establish a new global reserve currency, a type of money that would be adopted as the standard throughout South Africa, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and any other countries that would join the alliance. Currently, the US dollar is referred to as a reserve currency of the world and is utilized in the vast majority of global trade. Today, the US dollar accounts for over 40% of all international trade and is nearly exclusively used for crude oil purchases and sales. This simply means that every nation must acquire and keep US dollars. The only country that has power over the printing and destruction of this currency is the United States. In other words, the US may create more money if it needs to purchase more commodities from other countries, exporting its inflation to the rest of the globe. This is the US's immense control over the rest of the world since the Bretton Woods Accord in 1944. However, if the US dollar loses its role as a reserve currency, it may ruin the country, a goal that BRICS appears to be aggressively pursuing. So how will the new currency work? According to Putin's statement, the new currency would function like a basket that included the values of the currencies of the five BRICS nations, making it somewhat decentralized and more stable than the US dollar. It's also feasible that the BRICS currency will be backed by gold to give it even more strength. Ever since the first BRICS meeting, the five BRICS countries have bought gold, expanding their supply by thousands of percent annually. This doesn't even consider the recent discovery of up to $12 trillion worth of additional gold in Uganda, which is more gold than the current global supply. For the first time in 50 years, we may be able to have a currency backed by gold again, which would almost immediately make it the most valuable money in the world. However, these new resources will almost exclusively be mined by China. Now that BRICS wants to develop its own currency, the United States is probably terrified. In particular, if this currency were backed by gold, it would be terrible news for the West's ability to influence world trade. On the other hand, it would be excellent news for the economy of the BRICS countries. These five countries would have a stronger hold on the economic future if the BRICS currency were introduced. They wouldn't have to purchase or keep US dollars, and they could exert more influence over world trade. The US government would no longer be able to readily influence the economy of the BRICS countries, and the US would no longer have any control over their currencies. This would also provide the BRICS nations an almost unparalleled level of economic stability. For instance, the BRICS currency could still rely on the stability of the other four if South Africa's economy were to deteriorate on its own. As a result, the BRICS currency may be far more stable than the US dollar. In other words, it would become considerably more appealing for other nations to trade with it. In sum, the BRICS currency might quickly overtake the US dollar. However, the dominance of Western money has been threatened before, and the previous instance wasn't long ago in history. A coalition led by NATO staged an intervention in Libya on March 19, 2011. Several nations made up the force, although France and the US were its primary leaders. According to the UN Security Council, the intervention was a humanitarian one intended to stop Muammar Gaddafi, the leader of Libya, from committing alleged crimes against humanity and to avert the start of a new civil war there. The invasion of Libya, though, may have occurred for other reasons, and it is entirely related to money and power. There were rumors that Gaddafi intended to unify Africa prior to the invasion of Libya, and according to unclassified emails made public by the US State Department, he intended to create a new African currency to accomplish this, a currency known as the African dinar that is gold-backed. The power of Europe and Africa could have been substantially threatened by this new currency. This is because, at that time and even now, more than a dozen African countries, known as Francophone countries, utilize the CFA franc as their official currency. The CFA franc is tied to the euro, giving Europe enormous economic power over the countries that use it. These countries are once colonies of the French Empire. The nations using it must also have large deposits within the French treasury. If Gaddafi had successfully unified Africa under the gold dinar, it would have diminished the influence of the euro and Europe's economic dominance over the continent. Its strength would also result from the fact that it would be distributed throughout the economy of multiple countries rather than just one. Even if none of us individually possesses the might of a nation, we can all benefit from the actions the BRICS are taking to diversify and stabilize our assets. Hi. We hope you like watching this video and learned something important. If you enjoyed it, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to stay up to date on our videos. And make sure to leave your thoughts in the comments section below. This is Finance Sense, helping you keep up with all the latest trends in the financial markets and the economy. Until next time!